Good evening, friends. Now we are discussing simplex method. So for the given LPP is here, which is having the maximization function, and it is subjected to so many constraints here. So we need to find out the values of x1 and x2 when substituting in z, that has to maximize this objective function z. So that is the objective of this problem. Now the solution will go like this. Since the given constraints are having less than or equal to sign here, we are introducing the slack variables. That means whatever we have on the left hand side of the equation is less than whatever we have on the right hand side. That means we need to add some more thing here on the left hand side so that the left hand side become equal to right hand side. So we are adding the slack variables here, s1 and s2. If we have greater than or equal to sign here as constraints, that means the left hand side whatever we have is greater than the thing what we have on the right hand side. That means the left hand side is greater than right hand side. So if something is subtracted from left hand side, that becomes equal to right hand side. So then in that case, slack variables will be introduced with negative sign. But now since we have less than or equal to sign, so the slack variables will be added, but in case of greater than or equal to, we call them as surplus variables. That means the left hand side is excess than the right hand side, so we have a surplus here on the left hand side. So something will be subtracted from here to make a left hand side equal to the right hand side. Now we are introducing the slack variables s1 and s2 here. Now to find the particular solution of these variables x1, s2, x2, s1, s2 and z. Z is the objective function that gives the largest possible value for z. So finally, at the end of the solution, we need to find out which values of x1 and x2 will maximize my objective function z. So the augmented matrix for this system is this. So we have the variables x1, x2, s1, s2, and this is the objective function z. Then we'll take this constraints. So having the two variables x1, x2 and the surplus variables, so that is s1. So their coefficients are 2, 4 and 1. So that we are going to write here 2, 4, 1. So s2 is 0 and we don't have z in my first constraint. So its coefficient is also 0. Then if we take the second constraint, so we'll have x1, x2 and s2. We don't have s1 here, so their coefficients will be written. So x1's coefficient is 2 and here this is 2, and for s1 it is 0, then for s2 it is 1. So that is what we have written here. Z is not there, so its coefficient is 0. Then we'll take the objective function. So that is this. Z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2. Taking these two to the other side, the objective function is rewritten as this. So Z is having the coefficient 1. X1 is having the coefficient minus 3 and X2 is having the coefficient minus 4. So we are having x1 minus 3, x2 minus 4, and we don't have s1 and s2 in my objective function. Their coefficients are 0, so z's coefficient is 1. So here we have the coefficient of z is 1. So, and the solutions are okay. So if you take the first constraint, the solution is 120, and if you take the second constraint, the solution is 80, and if you take the objective function, its solution is 0. That is what we have written here, 120, 80, and 0. So this the last row is representing my objective function row. Now the initial simplex table from the system what we have written now will be written in the form of the simplex table. We have x1, x2, s1, s2, and z what we have here. The three rows are written. The first two are constraints, and the third one is the objective function row. So then the solution values are also written. So here the constraint, so that is the constraint number one is having the slack variable s1, and the second constraint is having the slack variable s2, and the objective function row, so that contains z. So now here, so we have to go for the most negative one, because if you take the objective function, so that is here, so z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2 earlier. So if I assign x1 0 and x2 0, my z value is also 0. So yeah, I slowly keep on increasing my x1 and x2. So finally my intention is to maximize z. So if you increase x1, so it is having the coefficient 3. So increasing x1 will not maximize my z value, whereas increasing my x2, so that is having the coefficient 4, so will maximize z. Suppose if I give x1 1 and x2 as 1, so this is now 3 into 1 becomes 3, but here this is 4 into 1 becomes 4. So instead of increasing x1, first I will increase x2, because having the higher coefficient, so my value of z also gets increased very fastly. So having the most negative coefficient, so here, so that is minus 4. So minus 4 is present in the second column, so that will be taken as the pivotal column here. So then you take the entries in the pivotal column, and you have the solution here. So solution values will be divided by this pivotal column entries. So 120 divided by 4, so that is 30 here. Then 80 divided by 2, so that is 40 here. So we have the two ratios here, so that is 30 and 40. Out of this 30 and 40, you take the least positive ratio, so that is 30. So you take that row as the pivotal row. So now we are having x2 as the entering variable, which was earlier taken as the non-basic variable. Time being, s1 and s2 were taken as the basic variables. Now finally my intention is to make my x1 and x2 as the basic variables, and getting rid of these slack variables, so that is s1 and s2. So now x2 is taken as the entering variable, and s1 as the living variable, that is the one which is in the pivotal row. So x2 is the entering variable, s1 is the living variable. So what I have discussed now, so that is written here. The most negative coefficient in the objective function is minus 4. So take that column which contains minus 4 as the key column. So here, so the most negative coefficient in the objective row, so that is minus 4. So you take minus 4 and the second column where I have minus 4 is my pivotal column. So now x2 is considering as the entering variable. So divide the solution by the entries in the key column. So as I said earlier, so that is 120 is divided by 4, so to get 30, and 8 is divided by 2, so that is 40. Out of these two, you take the least one, so that is 30. So now considering the first row as the key row, because the least positive ratio is present in the first row, you take that as the pivotal row. Now the intersection of the pivotal row and pivotal column will give the pivotal element. So we have here the pivotal element, so that is 4 here. So now make that pivotal element, so that is 4, as 1. So that is the row operation we have to do. So the pivotal element is now 4, it has to be made 1. So how it is made, and other entries in the pivotal column has to be made 0. In the sense, this has to be made 1, and the other entries in the pivotal column, that is these two, should be made 0. So how it is done? So we are dividing row 1 by 4 and taking it as row 1. In the sense, so if I want to make this 4 as 1, so 4 should be divided by 4. So then only this pivotal element will become 1. So that means this entire row will be divided by 4, so that the new row 1 will be obtained. So we'll have here 2 by 4, so that is half. So then 4 by 4, so that is 1 here. So then we have 1 by 4, then 0 by 4 is 0 only, 0 by 4 is 0 only, 120 divided by 4 is 30. So that is what we have written in the first row. So that is new row 1 is written here. Then the pivotal column other entries should be made 0. So these two should be made 0, for which we are doing the row operation here. So that is these two row operations. So that is R2, the new row number 2 will be made using this operation, so that the pivotal column entry, so here, right? So that we'll be having here, these two entries will be made as 0 here by doing the two operations here. So then the other entries are made here. So this is the new simplex table what we are obtaining. So now once again in the objective function row, so take the most negative one. So this process has to be repeated until there will be no negative entries in the objective row. So now I don't have any other negative entry, only this is my negative entry. So you are taking that particular column as the pivotal column here. So then we are having the ratios here. So then this ratios will be divided by the entries in the pivotal column. So this is divided by this. So 30 is divided by 2. So we'll get 60 here. 20 divided by 1 is 20 only. So then take the least positive value out of these two ratios. So that is out of 60 and 20. So 20 is the least positive ratio. So you take that particular row as the pivotal row. So now the intersection of pivotal row and pivotal column becomes the pivotal element. So now in the next iteration, what we have to do? So keep this pivotal element as 1. So it is already 1. So what we are doing? So divide this entire row divided by 1. So there is no change in the values. So finally, the pivotal element remains 1 only. So divide this particular row so by 1. So that is what it is done here. So that is so here then make the other values in the pivotal column as 0. So that is what we have written here. So that is R2. So that is nothing but R2 divided by 1. As I said, so this particular row number 2 is divided by 1. So there is no change in the entries. So it remains 1 only. So then the other entries in the pivotal column, so this half and this minus 1 should be made 0. For that, we are doing these two operations so that the other entries in the that particular column become 0. So this entire row is changed now. So that is R1. The new R1 is written here. Similarly, so R3. So here we are doing this operation R3, so to get the new row number 3 here. So now there are no more negative entries in the Z row, so that is the objective function row. So my pivotal the optimal solution is found now. So the maximum value of Z is 140, and you can see here that the slack variables S1 and S2 get departed. So the basic variables X1 and X2 have entered into the constraint. So now X1 is 20 and X2 is 20. So these are the two values of X1 and X2 at which maximum value of Z is obtained. So thank you.